Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video we are going to see how to remove left recursion. Now removing left recursion is very important. First of all, what is left recursion? See, whenever we are having any production in any CFG, that is context free grammar, whenever we are having any production like A gives A alpha or beta, in this case, see, this A is again called here. So this is actually known as recursion. Normally, as we know, in terms of our programming, what does recursion means? Whenever any function is calling itself, that is known as recursion, right? So here also, if you see, A is again calling A, like A is calling A, from here again A is called, again this will happen, again A is called, and similarly we will go in a forever loop, infinite loop. That's why obviously we don't want infinite loop, right? So we need to remove this left recursion whenever it is present in any production. Now it is known as left recursion because, as you can see, it is present in the left hand side, most left side in the production. Now A gives A alpha, if I am having something like that, then A will keep without doing anything else, A will simply keep calling A itself. So it will go in an infinite loop, and that's why whenever any such grammar is given in which it is having left recursion, our first task is to remove that left recursion and then move further. Fine. Now yes, we are having a definite formula for removing that left recursion. What the formula is, that whenever we are having A gives A alpha or beta, any production like this, and we want to remove this left recursion from this, so we are having the formula A gives beta A dash and A dash gives alpha A dash or null. Means this formula, this production I can convert into these two productions, and as you can see here we are having left recursion, but in this newly made productions A, but no left recursion is there, here A dash, but again no left recursion is there. So converting this production into these two productions, we can remove the left recursion, but the meaning remains the same. Fine. So simply what we will do is, in case of any grammar, if left recursion is present, we will simply apply this formula and remove the left recursion. Fine. Now with the help of this example, let us see how we will apply this formula. Now obviously, to remove the left recursion, first of all we have to detect that in how many places or which are the places where left recursion is present. Now if I see in my case, wherever there is no left recursion, we will simply keep the production as it is. So here in the first production, we can see that S gives ABC, means there is no left recursion, S is not calling itself, so simply I will copy that production as it is. Then second, A gives AA, so yes, here I am having left recursion. Fine, again A gives AD, means again I am having left recursion. So if I am taking one by one, so first let me take A gives AA, right, like A gives AA. So if I take this case, if I A gives AA and only B is there, so I am taking this B also. So if I take this case, so in case of this example, if I see, this is my main example how I can convert, and this is the production that I am getting in this example. So if I convert my this production with this standard formula, what I am getting, I am getting that the value of alpha is A and here the value of beta is B. So simply I have to put this alpha and beta in place of alpha and beta in these formulas. So I will get what? Putting this alpha and this beta, I will get A gives beta A dash, means A gives beta, that means B A dash, and A dash gives what? Alpha A dash, that is A A dash or null. Fine. So simply, first of all, I will copy these two into my answer. So A gives B A dash and A dash gives A A dash or null. Fine. Now here I have successfully removed this one left production of A gives capital A A, but again I am having second, that is A gives capital A D, that is, see, I am doing here, A gives, this is my quotient, A gives capital A D. So if I compare this with this formula, I am getting alpha equal to D, and again B is, remains constant as beta. So again I am getting alpha as D and beta as B. So replacing alpha and beta in this formula, I will get what? A gives beta A dash, beta is my small b. So A gives B A dash and A dash gives alpha, that is D A dash or null. So I will replace it here. Now if you see here, A gives B A dash is already present. So we will not write it again. But here A dash gives D A dash or null. Here null is already present, but D A dash is not there. So I will replace, I will add this D A dash also here. Fine. So this production, these productions of A are written into this form such that the left recursion has been removed. Now again B gives B B or E. So E is alright. B gives B B is again, B is calling itself. So again I am having left recursion. So again I will put this this formula into this. So I will get alpha equal to small b, beta equal to E. And after applying same formula in the same way, what I will get? I will get B equal to, B gives this small e, beta B dash, and B dash gives alpha, that is B, this B, B dash or null. Similarly, C is again calling C. This is also left recursion. Again, applying the same formula, I am getting alpha is small c, beta is G. So I will get C gives beta, that is G, B, G, C dash, and C dash gives alpha, that is small c, C dash or null. So this is my answer. This is the another form of grammar. Another form of the same grammar in which, fine, this is the another form of the same grammar in which the left recursion has been removed. So this is my final answer of the same grammar, removing the left recursion. Fine. Thank you so much.